Maya has a great selection of snapping tools. When mastered, will speed up and increase the accuracy of your modeling tenfold. This video shows what I believe are the most important things you need to know about these tools so you can use them in your modeling process. We're going to start by covering the main three snapping modes, beginning with Snap to Point, which lets us snap objects to points or corners, essentially any vertice in the world. Then we're moving on to Snap to Grid, which aligns any objects or components to the grid. And finally, Snap to Curve, which lets us snap two curves as well as edges on objects. The main method of using our snapping modes is to hold down our corresponding shortcut, and then we can move our objects or components in the 3D world and they will snap to whichever mode we're using. We can see our snapping modes at the top of our screen here, represented by these magnets. The first three are the ones previously mentioned. Starting from the left, we have Snap to Grid with a shortcut of X, Snap to Curve with a shortcut of C, and Snap to Point with a shortcut of V. Before we start snapping here, it's usually easier to see the lines we're going to snap to. We can turn on Wireframe Unshaded by clicking this little blue cube with the outline, or the shortcut to toggle it is Alt plus 5. Let's now begin some snapping using our Snap to Point mode. There's actually two different ways of snapping. First one, using our left mouse, which you can imagine is pretty simple. We just left click and drag on the move manipulator, and it's going to start snapping our object to the closest point near our mouse. The second method is using our middle mouse, and why it is a little trickier to learn, it has a few bonuses once you get the hang of it that make it worth putting the time in to master. To snap with this method, we just want to select the center of the gizmo to move on all axes, and then all you need to do is middle mouse click on the point you would like to snap to. Be aware you do have to move the mouse a little bit on the point you would like to snap to. The way I describe this is to middle mouse click and wiggle. The main reason why the middle mouse method is superior is we can snap objects off screen onto points that are on screen. What this means is we can more accurately look at the location of where we would like to snap to, instead of having to zoom out like this into these really wide views that include the object and the point we would like to snap to. You can see here in this example, as long as I continue to have the move gizmo selected, I can zoom into the point I would like to snap to, hold V and then middle mouse click and wiggle to snap that object exactly where I want it to. Moving these objects around while moving the camera is just another time saver, which is always relevant in the 3D industry. One little party trick that's surprisingly useful is you can spawn objects off screen and then double tap W to select the middle gizmo, and then you can just hold V, middle mouse click and wiggle, and snap it to where you're working on in your scene. Let's start some actual snapping now. First thing to realize is we can snap on one axis at a time or all axes at a time. You may notice whenever you've moved an object on one axis, the selected axis stays highlighted yellow. When an axis is highlighted, we can then use our middle mouse method to pick a point in space, and it's going to move to that point but only stay on the axis you've selected. In this case, only moving on the Z axis. With this knowledge, we gain the power to snap objects without needing a physical point in space. You can imagine this is great for things like aligning objects to the ground or having them at the same level as other objects that are floating in space. One important feature to use in conjunction with the snapping is the ability to move our pivot point. D is the shortcut to open up the pivot edit mode. You'll notice it's different if you can see the rotate and the move icons. Our snapping tools, of course, work while in this pivot edit mode. This means we could easily snap our pivot to the corner of this cube, we could snap it just to the bottom of the cube, or even the top. By altering where the pivot point is, we gain the ability to snap in unique and useful ways. You can see here in these examples, I've just snapped the cube down so it's aligned with the floor by putting the pivot on the bottom. If I put this across to the left here, I can now snap it easily to the wall. We could of course finally do this as well by snapping our pivot point to the corner of the cube, and this would let me align it really easily into the corner of this sort of room. The last thing to realize here is we can of course snap with just our components, so our face, edges, and our vertices. We can use these to align just parts of our models up to other things in the scene. You can see in these examples, it might be useful to take an object down to a ground plane, align it to a wall, or match the length of an object with another length in the scene. A little bonus tip here, never be afraid to add extra cuts to use as guidelines for your snapping. In this example here, you can see I add three evenly spaced cuts to this board, and then I can quickly snap my cylinder to these three points that I've created. And then even if I needed to at the end, I can take away the edges again. Snap to point is definitely the most useful snapping mode, but let's quickly have a look at snap to grid and curve to see what they might be useful for. Snap to grid is the easiest one to understand. It works exactly how you'd imagine. You hold X, which is the shortcut, and your object or component will now snap quickly and easily to your grid. Be aware if you change your grid settings, this will change how grid snap works. By default, it essentially moves in one unit values, as that's how the default grid is set up. The main use case for snap to grid is usually to align things with the center of the world. In this example, we'll prepare this box for mirroring by straightening up this edge in the middle and snapping it to the center of the world. To do this, simply grab the edges that need to be straightened, switch to your scale tool, and flatten them on the axis of the mirror, in this case, the x-axis. Now that they're straightened, we can just hold X and move on the x-axis only, and this will snap our line to the center of the world. Snap to curve only really has a few unique properties that you couldn't necessarily do with snap to point. Its main use here, as you can see, is holding C and then middle mouse clicking and dragging along an edge will let us slide along that edge. This is really useful for diagonal lines, as you really can't get that same snap with just a point. It's pretty useful for long edges on straight objects, but you can imagine you could have just snapped to the point on the corners and then slid across with the move tool anyway. So it's only useful sometimes just to save a little bit of time. Its last use, of course, is the namesake to snap onto a curve. This only works with the middle mouse snap, so you can't do the left click here. Its only real use is to array objects around a curve shape. It's not super relevant anymore now that we have sweep mesh. There are some other dedicated snapping tools in Maya, a really useful one being the snap together tool. You can find it in modify and then snap together tool. It does essentially what it says, it snaps objects from one to another. The way it works is you left click on an object, you get a little arrow, and then you click and drag and then click on another object, and you get these kind of connection. Just hit enter and it will snap together. This of course works with whatever face you click on the object. So you can imagine like this example, it's really useful for when you have an angled shape and you're trying to match the angle with another object, as that's pretty hard to do without a tool like this. Lastly, I'd just like to highlight live surfaces. These have a lot more uses than just basic modeling, but can be pretty useful for just distributing a bunch of meshes around a base mesh. To create a live surface, select your object and click this last magna icon in your toolbar. This will make the object live, and essentially what it'll mean is any move in the 3D space will be constrained to the surface of that live object. As you can see here, I just move around this sphere and it does not move off the object at all. Even creating a new object here, you can see it instantly sticks to the live surface straight away, and it will continue to do so until I turn off that live surface by clicking the icon again.